As you know, there are numerous applications of neural networks today in the context of computer vision. Just as examples, let's look at a few of these. Let's start with the one that we've been talking about, which is recognizing characters, in particular digits, handwritten digits. And so here are some results using the network that we just talked about, which is Nielsen's network. These are some inputs, and these are the activations produced by the network for these inputs. You can see in the case of 7, you get a very strong result, 0.97 here and close to 0 everywhere else. In the case of the 2, again, a very strong result right here for 2. In the case of this one, and we assume that's a 5, but you get a large number for a 2 and a 5. Well, fortunately, the output for the 5 is larger than that for the 2, so that still gets labeled as a 5. And this one is more interesting. We don't really know. If you ask me what this is, it could be a 3, it could be an 8. But here you see that you get large values for a 2 and a 3 and 8 as well. And so therefore, 8 ends up winning in this particular case. So it works pretty well. And here's a real-time implementation of this, which is done on a phone. Essentially open the camera of the phone and point it towards a character, and the app tells you what the digit is that is handwritten. So you see that working here. You see that on the bottom right corner is the result. Keep an eye on the bottom right corner right here. It tells you it's a 2. And here it says it's a 3, 4, 5, and so on. So it works pretty well. And now, one of the things I want to mention to you is that one of the major innovations in the context of neural networks is the idea of convolutional neural networks. This is particularly relevant to computer vision, because as you know, in vision, very often when we want to solve a problem, we want to take an image, an input image, and process it using filtering methods, often linear filters. And we know from our lecture on image processing, linear filters are linear shift invariant systems and therefore can be implemented as convolutions. So it's advantageous, as you know, to take an image and apply various convolutions to it so as to extract the most meaningful information for that particular application and then use the result to perform the task. Well, it turns out that that whole process of not only performing the convolutions, but also figuring out which convolutions are best for a particular application can be incorporated into the neural network itself. So here you see that you have an input image, and this image is being convolved with all of these kernels, K1 through K5. When you convolve an image with something, you end up getting an image. So these are your activations now. So very large activations, each one the size of an image. And you have certain other processes happening after that. And then you have your full network with weights and biases. The advantage here is that you can train this network where the parameters of the kernels right here are also treated as unknown. That is, not only is the network during training figuring out what the weights and biases in this part of the network are, but also the kernels, the convolution kernels as well. So that's a very powerful idea due to Lacun, and that has huge implications, particularly when it comes to applications in computer vision. So using these kind of networks, a lot of applications have been demonstrated. This is one by a company called Clarify, where you can upload your own picture and it will tag the picture. It'll tell you, give you sort of a symbolic description, if you will, of the picture. So here it says you have a dog, it's winter, there's snow, no persons here, frosty nature, wood, daylight, etc. So that's pretty nice. Even more remarkable is this one here, which says it's food, it's dinner. It says there's chicken there. That's quite remarkable because this could be something else. And says there are vegetables, mouth-watering as some sauce. I guess that's this right here. And then there's a knife. And this is the knife right here. So that's very good. This is a sort of a city view. It says city, skyline, skyscraper, office, harbor, water, waterfront, etc. And this has also been applied to videos. This is some work by Karpathy, where you're going to see people doing many different sports activities. And what this system has been trained to do using a convolutional neural network is to basically classify the activity. And it provides three of the top ranked activities. So in this particular case, it says mountain unicycling. And the second rank goes to canyoning, and the third one is base jumping. So I'll just play the video and you'll see the classifications change with time. So that's unicycling, which is good. It says kayaking for a moment. This one says free ride. Basketball in this case, makes sense. Wheelchair basketball, that's impressive. Mixed martial arts. Kayaking, creaking, and so on.